Here, Yogi, Virendra Yogi, beloved friends, whoever you are, wherever you are, whatever your occupation and profession, you have always an opportunity to become a wonderful human being, and truly you will be able to serve the mankind. And for this, what you need is dedication, commitment, a definite purpose, and you have to establish your foundation on truth, justice, peace, love, and non-violence. If you really develop these beautiful thoughts in your mind, because the thoughts can really create every condition, every environment, your personality, everything is based on your thinking. My best friend, Lord Buddha, Gautama Siddhartha said, we are what we think. All that we are arises with our thought we make the world. But the ignorant, indolent, thoughtless, these people, they do not understand the value and significance of thinking. Most of the time, they never think. What my best friend said, Albert Schweitzer, when he was interviewed in London, he really claimed it, that the biggest mistake of the mankind is that they never use their supreme, intricate and accurate machine which can really make them great. That is the power of your brain. Whatever the mind can conceive and believe, the mind can really achieve for you. So you just rely on your power of mind. That is called the intelligent substance, a very powerful substance. And that substance is directly connected with the universe. And universe will only support those people who are honest, magnanimous, and very sincere and committed. Whatever direction you want, you can really excel in that direction. There is no problem. The problem is only the people don't have destination, they don't have goal, they don't have mission, and that's why they are dripping the darkness of directionless. They don't know exactly where they are going, and that's the real problem of human being indulged in sorrow, suffering, grief and pain. Because once your mind is fully occupied, you are treading down all difficulties and dangers and moving towards your destination. You will be enjoying that journey because you love what you want in life. That's why my best friend, James Allen, wrote, you will be what you will to be. Let failure find its false content in the poor world environment. But its spirit is constant and is free. It masters time, it conquers a space, it carves the boastful trickster chance and fills a servant place. The human will that forces unseen, the human will that forces unseen, the offspring of a deathless soul can hew away to any goal, the walls of grand intervene. Be not impatient in delay, but wait. And as one who understands, when his spirit rises and commands, gods are ready to obey. The bottom line of this, my conversation with you, is that you are born as a human being. You are blessed with the power of your mind. Now it is your prime responsibility, and somebody should stimulate your intelligence to the perception and discovery of the truth that you yourself are a maker of yourself. By virtue of the thought you choose and encourage, and your mind is the master power, both to the inner garment of character and outer garment of circumstances. And maybe till now you have been defeated, you have been failing several times, and your life is nothing more than a bundle of sorrow, suffering, grief and pain. These are all because of your evil thoughts. Now if you want to make really a U-turn, you really want to become different, then change your thought process. What my best friend William James said, this is the greatest discovery of our generation. Just by altering your thoughts, you can alter your life. Another great friend of mine, Emerson said, Ralph Waldo Emerson, a man is what he thinks all day long. Another great man, Marcus Aurelius, said, a man's life is what he thoughts makes of it. Another great friend of mine, Vincent Peale, said, if you think positive, you will get positive results. If you think in negative terms, you will get negative results. And that's why one of the great friends of mine, William Ernest Henley, a British poet, composed a beautiful poet called Invictus. And there he lastly said, I am the master of my fate and I am the captain of my soul. Remember it. This is called the power of thought. Those who think great, they become great. Those who think little, they become little. And those who think very highly, they achieve greatly all the things on earth. There is no limit to our brain power. Simply we have to take full possession of our mind, control and direct it towards whichever destination, direction you want to go, you will reach there. But you have to pay heavy price for that. Sacrifice is essential. If you are escaping from hard work, blood, toil, tears and sweat, you cannot attain those supreme greatness in your life. For this you have to commit yourself, dedicate yourself and be ready to take the bull by the horn. You have never to run away from your hard work and all these. The two youths are with me. They are very promising and they have set a goal in life. Their goal is to be a true servant of the mankind. And they have taken the medical profession. They are caring the people who are in deep struggling for life. That is emergency. These boys are doctors. They are going to really treat those patients and give them life. Remember it. You yourself are the maker of yourself. The man is literally what he thinks. His character being the complete sum of his thoughts. So think purity, sincerity, honesty, integrity, determination, commitment, striving, seeking and finding different ways and means to become a person, a powerful personality of power, and so that you can really serve the mankind. Let's wish we should be the true servant of the mankind. He preth best, who loveth best. All things, both great and small, for the dear God who loveth us, loved and made all. That is the real meaning of life. Thank you very much, dear friends, for watching this video. Thank you very much.